Big thank you to Team Chaitanya for having me here. I'll be speaking on can we image drill in all situations. This is a question that was posed to me to answer here, but I think I'll be ending up with more questions. Drill is basically inability to delaminate or differentiate between the layers, that is the ganglion cell layer, IPL complex, the INL inner nuclear layer and the outer plexiform layer. And foveal drill is something which is more than 50%, that is 500 microns of the foveal 1 millimeter zone. When that is affected by drill, it is known as foveal drill. So I think there's a beautiful paper on quantification of drill by Dr. Dilraj Grewal, who said that he did, first of all, the foveal scan and three scans above and three scans below, spaced at 240 microns between each other. And observations were recorded for each visit for each of the 7B scans that were recorded. And he said that the horizontal extent is the length of the drill where differentiation was not possible. And the vertical extent of drill was the number of scans out of 7 with the drill calculated as a percentage. So vertical extent was a percentage. The horizontal extent was in microns. So the question given to me was, can we image drill in all situations? I have slightly modified it to, can we identify and quantify drill in all situations? So let us take some examples of, this is one example, one non-compliant diabetic macular edema patient in whom we could, with difficulty, because we are all learning how to identify drill, 500 microns of the foveal area. This is a straightforward case of drill recognizable and quantifiable. And this is a post-treatment. All the laminae are well differentiated, the bands are reaching up to the fovea, and there is no drill after treatment, although there is subfoveal fluid. Another example of diabetic macular edema with large cystoid spaces, 1,500 microns of drill is what I subjectively measured it as, and there was drill at different layers, as you can see. One on the nasal, on the temple side, the along the inner nuclear layer, and on the nasal side, on the outer plexiform layer. So 6 weeks post-Ozurdex, there was drill reversal. Another case of chronic diabetic macular edema with a broad drill, you can see that it is almost 4,000 microns. But there is some confusion in quantification in chronic edemas, as you can see in this particular patient, where you cannot trace all the layers and say that there is definitely drill or there is no drill. But when we treat these patients, the confusion seems to go away. The extent of the drill is similar to the previous scan. So I think drill is better identifiable in the absence of edema. So we can go back and see that there is no drill in the rest of the areas, whereas there is drill in the area where drill was seen in the post-treatment picture. This is a similar example of a patient in whom we could not identify drill in the pre-injection picture. But in the post-injection picture, you could see that there is definite drill. And when we went back to see the previous images, we saw that it was almost coinciding with the post-injection picture. So post-image, post-treatment images give some clue to identification of drill in the pre-injection images as well. So this is another chronic edema with drill. And post-treatment, the retina is so thinned that along with HRS that we are not able to make out whether there is drill or not. So this is an example of confusion with identifying drill even after the edema subsides. Just take you through some examples of one case of acute CRVO with a 15 days history, and this patient had no significant drill to begin with. You can see that although there is edema, all the layers, all the bands are traceable to the fovea. So there need not be drill when there is gross edema. And this is the post-injection. There is no drill at all in this particular patient. So a case of the first visit, this is another series of cases where drill was everywhere on the first visit. You can see there is a severe CRVO with a low vision. There is a drill reduction on the first post-injection visit. Partial reversal has occurred within a month. And you can see that because the patient missed one visit, there has been a recurrence of edema and drill. Ozurdex was given at this point of time, and there is persistent drill. So this is just to show that drill is quick to recur and is probably an indicator of ischemia. Intermediate uveitis is another scenario where we get drill. Again, questionable. I'm not very sure about this. I would like to ask the panel about whether this is drill or not. This quickly got resolved with just subtenous injection. So my observations and conclusions from what I have studied in the last 1 year after the last conference, drill usually correlates with both severity and chronicity. Drill can be imaged with fair certainty in acute cases. Identification in chronic edema can be difficult. Post-treatment images can give some clue to identification and quantification. And complete reversal seen in cases where drill was subtle. Thank you.